It's been years since the Uganda National Roads Authority degazetted vast land to pave way for the construction of the 95-kilometer Kampala-Jinja Expressway. While the government has progressed in the compensation of people with legal claims on the affected land, a big percentage of project-affected persons were living in fear of losing out after the government clearly stated it will not compensate them. The people with no legal claim on the land are 7,136, about 34% of the project-affected persons.
The people who have no recognizable legal right or claim to the land or assets that they currently occupy. For these people, the existing resettlement and compensation methodology approved by the chief government valuer is not applicable to them. And no PAP or no project affected person in this category has been compensated to date.
In the latest move to kickstart the 800 billion shillings project, the government has reconsidered its earlier decision and accepted to resettle these people who are mostly squatters on the affected land.
In the context of the loan agreement signed between Government of Uganda and the development financing institutions, these project affected persons are also eligible to compensation.
To take note of the status of land acquisition, compensation, resettlement and livelihood restoration of PAPs under the development of Kampala-Jinja Expressway PPP project. We also requested the cabinet to take note of the proposed methodology for the compensation, resettlement, and livelihood restoration of the project affected persons with no recognizable legal interest for land and assets they use or occupy. And we requested the cabinet to approve the proposed methodology for compensation, resettlement and livelihood restoration.
Unlike the legal claimants who are receiving monetary value for their land and property, people in category 3 will instead be resettled to another place that will be identified by government.
This time I have warned particularly the team of UNRWA and the local leaders to get accurate data which is easy to record. Like now we have this modern biometric, capture the biometrics of the beneficiaries so that once they leave, we know that they have been taken care of.
However, leaders from the affected areas say the issue of resettling these people rather than giving them monetary value for their property and land must be seriously scrutinized to ensure equitable and fair compensation.
Because some of the people own as little as 10 by 5 foot, which are very difficult to compensate. The difficulty is that someone who has 3 plots or 4, you cannot pay him either the land or amount of money as someone who has 1 plot.
Got some smile on our faces after a communication from the minister, Honorable Echelu, who has presented a government paper assuring us that people with no legal, those that are not legally recognized as per the law will be compensated.
Upon completion, the Kampala-Jinja Expressway will be 95 kilometers long and the second phase construction works will commence in 2023 to be complete in 2026. Like the Entebbe Expressway, Kampala-Jinja Expressway will be a toll road and will reduce the traffic on the Kampala-Jinja Highway. Story by Rachel Natwala for the news.